That's interesting, man. I like what Fnatic's bringing out. I just wonder, is it going to be enough in terms of damage? Well, if you guys think so, you know where to go. Hop on Twitter. At LL Esports, it's the place, hashtag FNCWin. We always see a lot of those, but keep on tweeting. Hashtag ROCWin if you think Rocket's going to take game one. Ooh, I can't wait to see how this early game shakes out.
Instantly, the excitement about this game goes up. Caps has his hands on Camille. We've got an old NA favorite of Soraka down in this bottom lane. Of course,
well,
Jezzy.
He spent
some time coaching on Immortals. It was Adrian that played a lot of Soraka, so I wonder whether he learned a few tricks that he's bringing over to the EULCS.
Good, bring some of that
good
stuff back.
Fun setup. I like this.
All right.
Very, very different out of Fnatic. And keep in mind, coming into this week, we were saying Fnatic, when they were playing meta comps, actually looked a bit better. So as on the tanks looked better. This is kind of meta champions put together in an order that we haven't really seen before, and then a Soraka put on top.
So, yeah, I like the creativity out of Fnatic. It's something we'd mostly seen from teams like the Unicorns, but now, you know, Fnatic is also embracing it. Let's see how this early game goes. Line of scrimmage start up. Nobody's going for any trickery here, but Jezzes will send a couple of autos flying with its dodging a bit.
Now, there are a couple of questions with this Camille in the mid lane. Against a Ryze, if you end up getting camped and fall behind, can be difficult. There's such a big propensity to snare. Allows you to kind of capitalize on any lead you have later on in the game with Ryze fairly easily.
Right.
Also, the long lane is a benefit for Camille. That insane jump range that can't really be utilized in mid lane, but both Ryze and Camille looking for that mobility. Edge with wind speakers, and as you'd expect, exhaust on that Ryze. Don't want to let Camille try and snowball.
Any chances, but yeah, as you rightly pointed out, the double TPs. Betsy's going to be able to match it somewhat with the Realm Warp, but we could be in for some seriously big divey plays. Caps is going to throw some vision deep and spot that, of course, it'll be the blue side start for Maxlore. Heads back to lane. Betsy's already in it.
Okay, so fun start with the draft. I want to now see how it transitions in. So Jezzes with the Soraka.
Very aggressive positioning right now. He's throwing those autos. They've thrown the exhaust on. It's matched onto Reckless, but they're pushing him all the way back to tower. The heal is burned and everything. Reckless is stepping very far forward. He's actually in danger of going a little low, but he's holding onto his heal. This time it gets used. Summoner spells just blown left and right.
But the thing is, this is ultimately going to end up favoring Fnatic with the amount of sustain they're going to have, the damage they can put down. Rocket kind of got a little baited into trading onto Jezzes early, thinking, well, if we can take control of Soraka's health pool to start this laning phase, then surely we can kind of keep Fnatic back, keep them down. And unfortunately, Soraka able to kind of facilitate a lot in that. Had the Q, heals herself back up, puts the damage down.
So here's where I would ask, with all those summoners burnt right now, it's flashes and flashes available for Jezzes and Reckless, does Maxlore now start to come down and maybe make an early move? But he was spotted on that red buff. So they kind of have this vision locked up, and he's actually going to look mid.
Yeah, Maxlore's going to look mid. This is what we were talking about with the difficulty of getting a Camille against a Ryze later on, if you end up getting put behind. But for this bottom lane, Reckless and Jezzes going to try and offset some of the push potential that Kianan and Wadid you would expect would have on Sivir Karma, normally a fairly heavy push lane, but Soraka and Varus can do fairly well themselves. And with Kianan taking a step back from the wave and no summoners, they have to pick and choose their little trades carefully on the bot side. Of course, the other advantage of having Varus is a three potion start with Soraka, incredible sustain compared to Kianan. Doran's blade start, only one potion.
Yeah. And, no biscuits to speak of. Amazing is actually going to run into Maxlore. He has had some trouble getting caught face checking a few times, but he has more tankiness. Threw the trigger seat on himself and threw up a brush as well, but he still had to burn that flash.
And that's one of the difficulties. Ooh, Shannon.
Very low in that bottom side. Reckless and Jezzes pushing forward very aggressively.
One of the difficulties of that, Ivan, if you do face check into somebody like a Kha'Zix that has this early game damage in that jungle pathing, You can really punish the Ivan, get the flash, and this is a very early roam. Spotted for a brief second, bot lane. Kjanen, the shields are down.
He's
in he goes.
Shot right onto Yharnam, nowhere to go, and it's first blood. It's actually picked up by Jezzes, who got the last hit.
Yeah, Jezzes is going to get it, but keep in mind, Caps now with this early roam, playing off the teleport mid laner, can recall and TP back into lane. This actually forces Betsy to go back and buy right now, otherwise he'll never make it to lane in time. Caps will lose maybe two minions off this. As Amazing comes into the lane, thankfully it was a cannon minion, so actually I think only lost one from that when you look at the experience and the farm, so despite Caps not getting the kill, it's not massively detrimental, but that assist is going to help him recoup some of the goal difference that he's currently down against Betsy. It's not the easiest lane for Camille.
No, definitely not, but building it for the team fighting. So as getting taunted into tower range, he's actually gone quite low here, and he has to walk away. Gonna be backing off for now, but still hanging tough. We won't talk too much about the top lane because the action is definitely gonna be in the mid and bot like we've been seeing.
And now you can see how this first blood in going to Jezzes actually will cascade through this bottom lane in the game. This early sightstone, 5 minutes is very early on a sightstone buy. Typically it's just past the 8 minute mark if you're getting it pretty early on support. So for Jezzes, it's gonna transition into bot side wards. They're gonna be safe in the laning phase.
You know who's not safe? Neither of these mid laners.
Yeah, because here come both junglers.
All right, there's the tax sweep, and they're just going to back off. Ah, oh, that was disappointing.
Well, I mean, Caps isn't really looking to go all in at this
point.
Yeah,
they're both level 5.
Yeah. Caps will get damage down, but with Max Lore around.
And the junglers definitely have focused a fair amount of time in this mid after they've been farming it out. I am really interested to see how differently Amazing can play this Ivern, because it did seem like he was shying away from some of these more emerging meta picks, and it's refreshing to see him changing that up in the later stages of this week.
At least in the first few weeks as well, they'd heavily banned out enemy Kha'Zix, as well as the Rengar that you would come to assume is basically banned in every game. So I'm liking seeing the Ivan out of Amazing. Bit of a change up in playstyle from him. Certainly we've seen the impact that Ivan can have, and you know, pairing it with the Maokai, you got yourself a Pharos to poke people down as well. Who, by the way, has a significant lead in the bot lane.
Yeah, and a lot of that has really been the pressure they've been able to exert and the vision that they've been able to deny anything from Maxlore, even if he wanted to come down towards that bottom side. I mean, really, the level one trade kind of decided a lot of things, it seemed. Caps, though, could be in trouble with Maxlore hanging out. He's got 6 right now, and he's caught in prison, but he hooks shots out. Flashing, and it's followed by Betsy, who just can't get the last hit.
Yeah, flash for flash, Caps gets out. The utilizing a lot of that mobility on that hook shot, getting himself available, well, out of the fight. That's one of the things that a lot of mid laners outside of the likes of Corki don't necessarily have.
Yeah.
Is that giant, giant mobility radius.
Yeah, and you got to take a look at the difference between these two junglers. I mean, it's been a little bit, I would say, more disappointing almost for Amazing, to be honest. But, you know, this game, he can turn a lot of that around.
Yeah, he can turn a lot of it around. I mean, the weird thing about Rocket when you look at their jungler is the fact that they kind of go through these peaks and troughs of erratic jungle proximity, where one game, Betsy will have like 40% jungle proximity, the next game, Maxlore will do nothing and just sit back. So this time, Maxlore's been more heavily focused around Betsy. It's been one of those more camp mid games. Understandable when the opponents get Camille in the mid lane.
I mean, they gave it to him, so hey, but they got themselves the Kha'Zix for it. We'll see if Maxlore can really, you know, step it up and start picking up some of those kills or starting to snowball lanes, but obviously the lane phase could end up being a little quieter since it is only that one kill that we've gotten off the rotation bottom. Amazing is actually hanging out in this brush. They've spotted that Betsy is sitting under tower and that Maxlore is hanging out towards the bottom side. Don't know if Fnatic spots that one.
Easiest blue buff of his life. Yeah. Caps.
I didn't even have to do anything.
Walks over, gets it. Interesting for Caps, we're seeing a departure. We were talking earlier with Cabochard about top lane Camille and how Sheen first is a great damage spike. You get a lot of damage from that based on the trading that Camille can actually offer. Caps opting away for that, going towards, you know, long swords, more towards what looks to be the beginnings of a phage. A lot of items build out of this mix of components. So I'm interested to see where Caps is going with this build. A lot of Camille's have gone that Trinity Force route overall.
We'll definitely have to keep an eye on it. And Caps is somebody who's not shied away from building for the most damage as much as he possibly can. The other day we saw him pulling out, you know, the Zed, the Katarina. Didn't get them any victories, but he's definitely been trying to step into that big carry, big assassin role. We'll see if they're able to snowball him ahead. Soaz roaming for Vision right now. Amazing will cover in lane for a moment. And you can see Rocket rotating their duo laners up top side. See if they get a fast push on.
Yeah, trying to get that fast push. Rocket have done this a couple of times. We've seen teams starting to rotate out when they feel like they're losing the bot lane matchup. You can see 86 CS to 59 right now in favor of Fnatic. They're going to try and push bot side out. They're bringing Camille down with Ivan as well.
Oh, they got the taunt on Reckless. He's not going to tower range because Jezzes was the one who was tanking. And now Caps is incoming with the hook shot. See, they dive onto Faxi. He knows something is up. Will he be able to get away? He's got his flash, but he's in the ultimatum right now. Blocking damage, they flash in. Reckless throws down the Chains of Corruption, and it's gonna be Caps that follows through.
Caps follows through, gets the kill. Big kill to start that snowball going. Soaz topside.
Yeah, Max Laura's on him. He hopped, skipped, and jumped, and throws the spikes. Soaz knows he has to back away, so it's a race to tower first blood. We have 0-0, but that is about to change. Looks like Fnatic should secure that one up just first, and Amazing is even going double time to pick up the Cloud Dragon. There goes Fnatic now, increasing that gold lead.
And they get tower first blood. Remember, it was Rocket that recalled out to try and get this play going first with the Sivir. Ultimately, Fnatic coming out ahead on the play, bringing their mid laner down early. And Caps even managed to recall out and get mid lane to hold that tower in time. There's the Sheen we were talking about. It's going to give him a large amount of burst damage. On top of that, Caps is maxing E for Camille. A lot of top laners typically max Q to try and get that trading damage on hit, but in top lane against Shen, where you can mitigate a lot of the damage, you want that burst damage on E. So Caps opting for the same kind of thing in mid lane as well, wanting to burst down any targets up front and try and get himself out. So this was the dive play. Reckless taunted under the tower. Didn't really end up doing too much, and Faxi right now knows he's basically dead, despite there being a ward. Camille is so mobile that you just get into the lane, get that massive slowdown, and this is the layering Fnatic are gonna have for the rest of these small-scale skirmishes. It's Camille ult into Varus ult into Equinox silence, and everybody kind of just dies.
Yeah,
that was there.
Yeah, before the season started, I was actually kind of thinking to myself, hey, with all the mobility, you know, we see like some Talon plays coming out. I really want to see that kind of champion. Well, I mean, who needs it when you can get your hands on Camille? It's a good gap close, just ridiculous. Fnatic have to be very happy with how that went down. One kill to the mid lane Camille. They got tower first blood. They got a dragon on top of it. And now they're wailing away up top, and Faxi's a little late to the party here. Reckless will get locked up, though, in the mid. Exhaust is on. Bestie running through all of them. They're bringing in the Shen. Reckless, the heals are just not enough, and Bestie will get the kill. But Fnatic get a tower, and they rotate down. Bottom teleport spent by Soaz, looking for Yharnam. Should be able to clear him off.
And because they just saw Shen and Ryze mid lane, Soaz can hold the bot side tower. That just took four people from Rocket to actually take Reckless down in the mid lane through the heal, through all of Soraka's heals as well. And that's only going to get more difficult. There's going to be a Maokai in that fight. You're going to have a Camille keeping on top of people at the same time. You can see what Fnatic have started to do. And yes, it was risky to put this Camille in the mid lane up against a Ryze. Yes, it's kind of risky to have outside of that what could be perceived as a low damage comp, but Reckless has enough damage himself. All of these heals and shields and you name it, Reckless had it, and it took Rocket a while to get it. So they ultimately get the kill, but lose out on the tower trade thanks to the teleport out from Soaz. Hyunim would have liked a little more time on his own in the bot lane just to push that wave in, get the tower damage down, but Fnatic were right on top of that.
As you said, Rocket's still trying to buy some time, but they may not have it as Caps runs smack dab into Maxlor through the ultimatum. He's going to have to flash back, and Daisy taps in, blocking Rocket. Betsy coming through the middle. Caps is coming back in for round number two as the teleport is channeling here. It's going to finally finish, and Faxi has joined the fight. This has gone pear-shaped for both teams, and they back off no kills.
Yeah, Caps didn't quite have enough damage to finish off Maxlor. He thought he could, but through everything what it was bringing with the shields and everything else to keep him alive, wasn't quite enough damage. After that Triforce, I feel like that fight is going to go a little bit differently, and Maxlor's probably going to be dead before the help arrives, but Rocket turned it around, and Fnatic appear with everybody else. So back and forth fight. Fnatic instantly moved to the bot lane, and look at the strength of this Fnatic composition. They have enough survivability to push two towers at once.
No hesitation from them, but Maxlor is jumping in, and Caps immediately has to bail out of there. Still, Fnatic, almost guerrilla warfare, in and out before Rocket can really respond fast enough, and this is what's helped them build up this 3K gold lead. Two towers to one, Cloud Dragon available. And it is not going to be Elder Dragon next. That is not correct.
No, it is not. The dragon it will be is Cloud next when it does come up.
Yay for speed boosts. Foxy's up top.
I mean, that's a significant help for the likes of Caps, who's looking to just assassinate and get everything they can. It'll actually help compensate a little bit for the fact they're against a Sivir and a Karma, who are going to try and run at you quickly. So as long as you're not in combat, Fnatic double Cloud Drake will help.
Betsy, entry with Soaz under tower, distract him a little bit before he pushes the wave out. He's able to do it. Maxlore there. He's waiting for backup. A lot of vision invested by Rocket in this bottom side of the map, mostly throughout that river. Yharnam and Wadid pushing in the mid against Reckless and Jezzy. So Rocket are definitely holding. I mean, there's some hope for them. They have some shields, some sustainability like we saw earlier on for themselves. So Caps has a hard time bursting people down. Reckless, even though he can poke from afar, may not be able to do it for long. But at 15 minutes, no, Rocket are not doing too bad. They just got to stop this gold snowball.
Yeah, they got to stop that snowball. The problem is Maxlore would like to do that by picking people off. Difficult when there's a Soraka on the enemy team who kind of just casts Wish and suddenly they get half their health back again, and then if Soraka's anywhere nearby, she just continues to heal and heal and heal.
True.
Means Maxlore needs to basically blow somebody up before anybody can reply, and that is difficult when you're facing off against an Ivan, you're facing off against a Maokai. Of course, Camille will end up getting some damage reduction if she tags you. So, not a lot of squishy targets available for Rocket to kind of exploit, but Rocket have a pretty insane late game with Sivir, with Ryze, with this Kha'Zix.
Yeah, I mean, that's very true, and you've got a Shen on your side too. I mean, we've seen what the Shen-Kha'Zix combo can do when you just leap in there with a massive shield. This means Rocket should also really be trying to contest this Cloud Drake when it comes up in the next minute. Question is, can they do that?
Right now, I think they're probably wanting to avoid it. Looking at itemization, you can see Sivir still not on one completed item. Oh. Reckless has the first. Here they go.
Here comes Maxlore. He's a little bit behind the 8-ball there, and Daisy's going to try to block some damage, but they caught Jezzy. They blow him up before it even begins, and Foxy getting one kill there. Yharnam staying back for just a second, and Soaz tries to come and get the knockup. They melt through Maxlore. They take down Foxy, and now the rest of Fnatic are cleaning house. Betsy on the run trying to pick off Caps, but that damage from Camille was just too real. And Rocket take the worst end of that one.
Daisy's a little excited at the end of that fight, jumping forward trying to catch down Betsy.
That's one scary cupcake stress.
I know, right? And that was a scary cupcake that actually kind of deterred the fight just long enough for Fnatic to turn themselves around and win the fight convincingly as they get another tower from mid lane. This is what we wanted to see out of Amazing. This is less about going Elise, trying to just snowball one lane and trying to build AP and do everything you can to win the game, which can be the right tactic. But everybody that is getting their hands on Ivan is seeing the strength of utilizing Daisy in these fights as almost a bodyguard, as a deterrent that can just push back the start of a fight for so long. And Amazing does that very well in that fight. It's going to be a second Cloud Drake going over to Fnatic as Rocket can't do anything.
Yeah, really not a lot you can fault Amazing for in this particular game. We were a bit hard on him early on, and he did get caught out at that level one, but did not die for it. Now, here was the attempt from Rocket that just did not work.
Instant Daisy as Faxi goes in. Jezzy's gets blown up in this fight, and that's important because that Soraka really is one of the key points of this. Caps had enough time to get back out of the lockdown, or at least the zone from his ult. And Reckless, because Daisy was next to him this entire fight, has just been able to pop off damage time and time again and stays safe. And the fact that Caps is a big enough deterrent, Daisy's a big enough deterrent, they only get Jezzy's, means Fnatic have so much damage at the end of that fight that Hyannon's low, Betsy's running away, Maxlore can't really survive either.
And you talked about them needing to scale as well. I mean, this is a scary late game team, but I mean, Fnatic have a fair amount of power here. You have the Trinity Force completed on Caps. He also had the Tiamat, so he has some damage. You've got a two-item Ivern here that's going to provide a hell of a lot of protection between the Redemption and the Locket. And then you've got a big frontline Maokai. I mean, it's hard to melt through this, so I like that Rocket focused Jezzes, but they just didn't have enough on the cooldowns to make any more happen.
Well, that's one of the things you've always kind of got to do against the Soraka. Otherwise, she runs around and heals everybody.
It's a good old game tactic. Kill the medic first, and then, you know,
We need him for Challenger tomorrow.
You're right, not that medic.
Join
just
that
general.
Team
I'm speaking
this week.
In generals.
Of course, Challenger will take place tomorrow. Yeah. Just a small little plug. Because
nice.
I mean, one of these teams, if they end up at the bottom of the group, which Rocket are currently, at the end of the split, will be playing against the Challenger team for their spot in the LCS. So a lot on the line as Fnatic are looking to maintain distance from the bottom of the group in this setting. Two dragons already in their favor. They're ahead in kills, ahead in gold, ahead in towers, you name it, they've got it. Mm-hmm. And they have a fairly scary 3-0-2 Camille. It's got Trinity Force and a Tiamat alongside it. So this is the kind of basis they want to be out on the side lanes with this Camille, push down towers, and then kind of regroup a little bit when Soaz is ready to come into the fight alongside Amazing.
Yeah, talking about being a little bit risky to pick this Camille, but it definitely seems to be in Cap's wheelhouse, and he's made a lot of work happen with it. If you can keep to those side lanes, this is exactly where Fnatic are comfortable right now. We're getting close to that 20-minute mark, just a few more seconds. The gold lead above 5,000 now for Fnatic as they've controlled both the dragons available. They have a lot of speed available outside of that combat. There'll be a Mountain Drake coming up next, but Fnatic haven't needed that much help knocking down objectives.
No, they really haven't, and honestly, a lot of this comes from not only the level one, but the play that came a little later when Cabs roamed down to the bottom lane with Amazing. They broke open that tower, got the first Drake, got the first kills, started the snowball going, and they haven't really looked back. They've been able to utilize a lot of this vision control on the bottom side fairly well, and now they're swapping it over to the top side. They want to try and focus on Baron control, trying to focus on these inner towers as well, just trying to catch anybody they can coming through the jungle, because if Maxlor gets caught out by Cabs, Maxlor's basically dead.
Yeah, and he did get caught out by Amazing, but fortunately for him, Licorice doesn't do that much damage on its own, but there's a Realm Warp coming in for Betsy, and instantly Daisy's there to intercept it. Fox is stopped up for just a second. A hail of arrows comes in. Rocket are pushed back, and there's a teleport now coming as we see everybody from Fnatic turning on that immediately, and Cap's going around the side looking to hunt down Betsy.
Looking
he hookshots over, gets put in Rune Prison, but he's going to hop forward for an ultimatum. Betsy can't go anywhere. Soaz, Twisted Advance is on. He's going to flash, but it may just be too late. And Cap's with a Rampage kill. Betsy, meanwhile, is keeping everyone busy. And it's going to be Maxlor that goes down next. Attack sweep to sweep Rocket aside. And it looks like they're heading for Baron.
So as slams the ground, flashes forward and makes sure they can get a second kill for that to open up the Baron. It was fairly clean from Fnatic. Teleporting right into the middle of the fight causes Rocket to run back away from any kind of engage. Caps just walks down from the top lane. Faxi's here, he's dead.
And that's a Shen that they just melted through, and they're right back on top of the Baron. Rocket looked like they were going to high-five into that one as he stepped a little too far out, so no chance here for Rocket contesting this Baron, none whatsoever. As it's 22 minutes into the game, they now extend that gold lead all over.
That's a Shen with zero completed full items right now. So this is the engage that Maxlor was looking for with Betsy. And Faxi, again, get Daisy into the front of the fight. Blocks off a lot of the things. You can see Betsy not really able to output a lot of damage there as Daisy was stuck on the corner as Caps jumps around. If this is a 1v1, maybe Betsy can get out, but between the ultimatum, Betsy even uses Exhaust here. Soaz comes through, locks Betsy down. That's kill number one. Watch Soaz. I believe it's a Q flash here as he connects with Maxlor, gets the CC through, and is able to pick up that second kill. Fnatic turn for the Baron. Nicely played by Soaz. We had a lot of criticism for Soaz and Amazing back on Thursday, their series where they got caught out again and again. This time, zero deaths so far. Fnatic is snowballing.
And he jumps right on to Betsy. Once again, Caps, no fear, no hesitation. They lock him up in the chains, and Reckless is even able to get a kill for himself. Yharnam on the hunt backwards. Soaz is tanking the front of this all as they take down the tower. Betsy will tag in forward, and with a wave of Baron-empowered minions, Rocket are looking to try and hold on to their base, but it won't be so easy. 23 minutes, Fnatic are knocking on the front door. They've got one, and that inhibitor's gonna look very tasty.
We mentioned it briefly earlier, Pyre, about how Rocket needed time in this game to get Sivir and Ryze to a point where they had damage. The damage output is not there yet. Rocket don't even have their tanks up to a point where they can sustain through the damage that Fnatic are outputting. I mean, this is going to be a slow kill because Maxlor is going to get hit by Betsy and Amazing's going to run away.
Yeah. So in fact, he's just going to swag walk away. That's kind of where Fnatic are at in this game, and this is way too early for Rocket's liking. It's just kind of falling to pieces for this team right now, and Grabs is taking the time to take the notes, but I mean, he can't be super happy with how this is going.
I think first note should be don't let Camille go to red side if available. Honestly, I think it's such a significant thing. This is the first game we've had in Europe where that has happened, right? Camille has been available and it hasn't been picked. Fnatic knew what they were doing with it, building a composition that they could very easily run off two carries and then two tanks, and a Soraka that is just healing everybody up. And Fnatic have done a very, very good job in setting themselves up for a quick win against Rocket.
It has to feel good after the performance they had up against Misfits. Very redeeming for this Fnatic squad, who's looking to be a little bit better than their placement would suggest, but they're going to have to fight it out first. The ultimatum lands onto Foxy here. Maxlor in the back, but he's dealing with Daisy, and he's just not getting the best of it. Flashing backwards now, the rest of Rocket, and their base is falling apart. Betsy's going to get the Shen Shield, and it might just be enough to keep him alive, but he's running towards the wrong part of the map, and he's gone down. Foxy now, they're flashing for him. They finish him. The base is in shambles, and three Rocket members are left to deal with all these waves.
And this is a big shot fired back towards all the critics from Fnatic earlier in the week. They had a pretty insane draft with what they picked up. Difficult maybe to predict Caps playing Camille, but Fnatic have done great in game one.
Absolutely, and they're gonna finish that one off in style. Caps goes godlike as he flashes in for the finisher, and with the Baron-empowered super minions in tow, they will take down the Nexus turrets, they will take down the Nexus, and they will lead the series 1-0 over Team Rocket.
I don't think we're going to see Ivern and Camille on the same team ever again in the EULCS this split. That's the caveat on patch 7.2. But anyway, that combination is disgusting. Ivern is strong, Camille is maybe even stronger, and you put them together and you're like, okay, well, we'll handle it with a slow scaling comp is never going to work.
Yeah, and even though they had some early power potential in the Kha'Zix, he was unable to get a single kill that game because apart from the shields, you've got a Soraka. Jez is bringing out that NA flavor and it worked out.
Yeah, it definitely worked out. Honestly, a lot of this game, that early play with the Ivern and the Camille roaming down towards bot lane, the fact it worked out so perfectly for Fnatic was a big foundation on this win, but Caps,
he popped off, man.
That guy looked insane on Camille.
He was 8-0-5, 100% kill participation. He was everywhere, and he was flashing, hookshotting. I mean, you can't predict for that kind of distance, and he made it look so easy.
Yeah, we were wondering, like, hey, if the Ryze can get ahead, that's a big if. If Ryze could get to the late game, shut down the Camille, but Camille went to other lanes and just completely got all of the glory.
I mean, this looked exactly like what he was trying to do on the Zed, on the Katarina, but I mean, on the Camille, it worked down. So now, to break down how Fnatic took game one over Rocket, we're going to send it back to the analyst desk.
Thank you very much, Pyro. Of course, to really break this down, we're going to start with the pick and ban. We want to look into some of the interesting choices that came out here on the side of Fnatic. Particular surprises, of course, Camille making it through, Soraka showing up, but I'm curious, what stood out most to you, Cabo Jordan?
It was interesting to flex it to mid lane, but I think it had some flaws in the Fnatic draft. Like, we normally we expect bot lane to get pushed in, like the Silver Karma, it cannot get pushed. Top lane, Shen is playing against Maokai, which is like fine early, and Ivern is not so much pressuring him, so he can push as well. And we saw Ryze at the advantage actually 1-1 against Camille, so they normally should get all pushed in, but it all crumbled a bit because of the level 1 bot lane trade that I guess Kripo is going to talk about.
I mean, yeah, I love my bot lane, but yeah, I definitely agree with Cabochard here. This is one of those situations where we look at a game, Fnatic, 25 minutes stomp, they can be so proud of themselves. But they have a draft with three losing matchups in the early game and a jungler that has a really weak moment at level 4 that can't actually duel very well. We saw it, if Ivern gets to duel Kha'Zix pre-6, he dies. So technically speaking, from like a holistic point of view, Rocket have a way into the game right there. But the main crux is that your bot lane pushes, and that went wrong. And we have the replay that we can watch again because it's just, there's so many mistakes on like a fundamental level, and it's really smart for Fnatic to look, they're early aggroing the wave, so they should never get two hits on the minions before the enemy team. Wadid misses Mantra Q. If you are a professional League of Legends player and you miss Mantra Q early game, like, you can FF. Like, you just forfeit the lane here, right here. This is like, and you don't even have to hit the Soraka. If you just send the Mantra Q out to the creeps and the Rocket bot lane just played on top side of the lane, no jungler will be close. There's no level 2 gank shenanigans going on. You can get the push, and then you push in Soraka Varus, and they do nothing all game. They just farm. But then this then happens down when Caps starts showing up, and obviously Cabo mentioned it, Ryze had the advantage 1v1 versus Caps. If Caps doesn't get these kills on side lanes, then he will start snowballing.
I mean, on the other one hand, while the draft does kind of leave a lot of vulnerability for Fnatic, I think we do have to praise them. They get the early flash advantage, and Caps immediately capitalizes
on it. Super
well
played. Yeah. But the amount of effort it took to like get there and variance is just like, I don't think this should happen with this draft.
Yeah, probably not. But then we saw like they actually snowballed it pretty well. They get bot Tor, and then they get top Tor when they send the Camille there. And then in team fight, it was really well set up with Ivan, Maokai, Soraka. Like when you're ahead in this comp, there is no way you can lose it. So
yeah, I like what Cabo says there. The combination of Soraka and Ivan with two redemptions. Soraka's main weakness is that she eventually runs out of health. If she doesn't get caught. With double redemption, you get healed twice, so you can just keep healing people in return. It's just so hard to play against.
I mean, it felt just nearly insurmountable once that lead was built. I want to take a look now at a replay where we see kind of where Fnatic started to extend that lead. And despite Rocket building a good comp, once again, it feels like the decision-making was just not there.
Cabo, we see Maxor and Wadid here run to the mid lane to make a pick instead of kind of trading turrets, what Fnatic was kind of forcing them to do. Do you think this is the best choice to go for these picks, or would you rather see them trade the turrets?
Yeah, no, they have to trade for sure, but I guess once again they are slower on the play, so they are thinking maybe we can get mid kill and then get mid Tor, but here they just get one kill, the wave is pushed in, they lose top Tor, and okay, TP is bad and he defends the Tor, so it's one kill for one Tor, I guess, worth it.
Not really worth it, especially since Sowaz gets to soak up that experience. And Shen falls further behind in the matchup then as well, because he was zoned off. And they were trying to make something work here, Rocket, but they were accelerating at the wrong points. And I think that was forcing them to struggle a lot against Fnatic, who were in complete control.
So this looks honestly pretty bad from Rocket's point of view. This is exactly how you don't want to lose a game. Get a good draft and then throw it away based on individual mistakes. Now I'm curious, as we come into the next game, what needs to change here for Rocket? Because if the drafting is good, is it just a matter of changing your in-game performance? Or is there something else that they can draft to make this easier for themselves?
I don't know. I think they need to understand what are their composition strength and play that out properly, because with that early game bot, as we said, there is no way you can get out after.
Yeah, curious. Of course, Maxlor, we expected him to be potentially on more supportive champions to enable his lanes. He took the Kha'Zix much more, kind of self-centered, wants to snowball ahead. Do we think that will change coming in, or does the Kha'Zix play fine? It just came down to the early game execution.
Like, Kha'Zix is still a really good champion, and into Ivern it was fine. And like, maybe if they know they can all push, then Kha'Zix can invade Ivern, and like level 3, Kha'Zix can never lose. So, maybe we can see that next game.
Yeah, like, if that's the plan, if you're Jungler, I don't think we can blame anything on Maxlor here. If you have expected lanes to win and they lose not only like the lane, but this hard to the point where enemy mid can just dive bot level 4, then you have bigger problems.
Yeah, falling apart in the early game, never what we want to see. Kind of disastrous, of course. Quick cleanup by Fnatic. We'll have to see if they can repeat it in game 2 or if Rocket will bring it back. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we will see that second game, and we'll see you guys in 3.5.
For a brief second, bot lane Kjaanen, the shields are down, in he goes!
Shot right on the Yharnam, nowhere to go, and it's first blood! It's actually picked up by Jezzes, who got the last hit. And now Caps is incoming with the hook shot. Did they dive onto Faxi? He knows something is up. Will he be able to get away? He's got his flash, but he's in the ultimatum right now. Blocking damage, they flash in. Reckless throws down the chains of corruption, and it's gonna be Caps that follows through. Put in Rune Prison, but he's gonna hop forward for an ultimatum. Betsy can't go anywhere. So as Twisted advances on, he's gonna flash, but it may just be too late. And Caps with a rampage kill with the Baron empowered super minions in tow. They will take down the Nexus turrets. They will take down the Nexus, and they will lead the series 1-0.